I'm going to describe the rock salt structure, which is a crystal structure that some metal oxides have. For example, iron oxide, FeO, has the rock salt structure. And so what it consists of, it's a cubic structure, and I'll build the structure up to make it a little easier to visualize. And what I'm looking at initially is just the oxygen atoms. So these blue circles represent just the oxygen atoms in the structure. An oxygen atom at each corner of the cube. Now let's slowly add in where the other oxygen atoms, because the oxygens possess the face center cubic structure. So I've added one oxygen atom, this one here, which represents an atom on the face of this cube. And then we'll have atoms on the other faces also for the face center cubic structure. So now here's an oxygen atom on the bottom, one side of the face, the other side of the face, and then we build up until we have six atoms on the faces. So now we're showing the complete face center cubic structure. At the center of this cube is an octahedral site. So I've drawn these three lines to represent the center. So if we were to put an iron at the center where these three axes intersect, that iron would be an octahedral site. It's called an octahedral site because these six atoms, this atom, these two, this one, and this one, if we form an eight-sided structure, an octahedral structure, and the iron now will be in the center to create, would be the first atom that I'm locating in the rock salt structure. We have to have an atom in each of the octahedral structures. So I'm showing the iron atom. The iron atom is smaller, the ion in the structure is smaller, so it fits in the octahedral site of these oxygen atoms. And then we have, and I won't draw them in, but we have them now in all these locations, such that if we were to add up the structure, we should have one iron for every oxygen in this crystal structure. So let's look at the oxygens first. We have eight corners. Those are each shared with seven other. So we have eight corner atoms, but we only have 1/8. So that's one oxygen atom in our structure. Six face atoms, this one and five others. Half are in this structure, half are in the next unit cell. So we have 6 × 1/2. So we have total of 4 oxygen atoms in this unit cell. So let's look at iron. We have one in the center, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. We have 12 that are on the edges, and those are each shared with 3 others. So we have 1/4 of 12, which is 3. So we have 4 iron atoms. So indeed we have the correct stoichiometry, and this is a representation then of the rock salt structure, where these are oxygens and this is iron, as well as each of the X represents iron.